Very good morning. And in this video, I would like to present. I like to make a video on SAP production planning. So, what is production planning? So, how much it is important? So, what are all these applications? So, these matters. And production planning, I can say it is a process of aligning demand with the manufacturing capacity to create production and procurement schedules for the finished products and components of materials. So SAP PP, I can say it is an important model of SAP. So it tracks and makes record of the manufacturing process. For example, the planned and actual cost, also the goods movement from the conversion of raw material to the semi-finished goods. So it is fully integrated with other SAP models such as MMM, SD, warehouse management, quality management, FICO, PM. So it is a tight, I mean everybody knows actually SAP is a tightly integrated ERP models, having a different integration of different streams. So normally organization actually in case of production planning, so when we talk about it, in any live production planning model is concerned, the locations of manufacturing plants and storage within the plants should be available in the system. So the important here is I can say the importance of plant and storage location in production planning is all production master data is created at a plant level, and planning activities are performed at a plant level, and production confirmation process and related goods movement occur at plant and storage location level. So important thing for a plant and storage, why we need a plant and storage location in PP, we can say all the production master data is created at the plant level, and the planning activities are also performed at a plant level. So production planning is nothing but a planning is very important, and production and execution is very important. So everything is taking place at the plant level. So plant and storage locations are very important. And so production confirmation process, I can say the confirmation of production execution. So and related goods movement. So everything is occurred at the plant level and the storage location level. Now comes the master data in SAP PP. So when generally speaking about the master data in production planning, so for any company, static or whatever it may be, so there are 5 important master data maintained for the PP. So those are, I can say, the material master, first one, and then actually the bill of materials, so work centers and routing, and then production version. So these are the 5 important master data thing in SAP PP. Okay, so what are the, I mean, if anyone is asking what are the master data available in PP, then we can see the material master, then bill of materials BOM, and then actually the work center, and then the routing, and then actually we have the production versions. So first we talk about material master. So what is a material master? So what are all the information contained in the material master? How it is important in a production planning? How the material master is very important in case of production planning? So these are the important questions which everyone's mind is concentrating on. So as already know, actually production planning is one organization's central data repository of a particular material. It contains all the views, that is material related views, basic data related things, sales views, then purchasing views, then warehouse management views, quality management, costing, accounting, production resource tools, whatever it may be, actually general plant data. So everything is considered in a material in total or in a nutshell of a material master. So the material master contains information on all the materials that company procures, produces, and stores. and it sells. So it is a number uniquely identifies a material master record, and hence it is a material. So in case of ECC and the previous version, it is a 18 character length code, and whereas in say S/4HANA, so it is 40 character length. The material master length is 40 character length. So materials with the same basic attributes are grouped together and assigned to a material type, such as a finished raw material or semi-finished, so whatever it may be. So it depends on the material type and grouping it forms. So actually, if anyone is asking what is the purpose of a material master, so answer would be to purchase a material, and second thing, for goods movement posting, such as goods issue or receipt in a inventory management, and also for your physical inventory postings, and third one, an invoice verifications for posting invoices, and fourth one, in sales and distribution for sales order fulfillment process, and fifth one, in production planning and control for your material requirements planning, scheduling and production confirmation process. So these are the important areas we need to consider the material in SAP. So next comes the bill of material. So bill of material is nothing but it's like it's kind of onion peel. Actually, the topmost finished material is over that is external cover, and within that we have the semi finished, and within that we have the raw material. So the level zero to from top level, like level three to level zero, or whatever it may be, depends on the material type and the levels it is considered for a particular organization. So it depends on material type also. So the bill of material. So a bill of material, I can say it is a complete formally structured list of components together with the quantity required to produce the product or assembly. So the BOMs are used in the material requirement planning and product costing. Okay. The BOMs are normally used in the material requirement planning and a product costing. We can also create up to 99 alternative bill of materials for a single product. So this is amazing. Actually, we can create 99 different groups for a single material. So for products having variants, we can create a super BOM which has all possible types of components. Used to manufacture different types of variants, and appropriate components is selected based on the characteristics chosen in the sales order. So this normally, actually, we can say the sales order BOM. Actually, we have production BOM, material BOM, sales order BOM, different BOM types are there, and we are creating in sales 01. And for example, the product cycle can contain all types of frames with different colors and sizes, and the desired frame is selected in the production order based on the color and the size chosen in the sales order. Okay. So that comes into a criteria. So it depends on the different sizes and colors, and so that determines the selection criteria. And next come work center. So what is a work center? So work center is nothing but a particular kind of work is taking place. Either it may be a drilling, tapping, or say galvanizing, arc welding, or whatever it may be. It is a part of the product line or a production line or a process line. In case of process industry, we can say one workstation in a process lane like that. So work center is a machine or a group of machines where the production operations are carried out. Work centers are used in your task list operations, and that is called a routing. So collection of work center forms a routing. So normally work center contains the data for scheduling, first one scheduling, and then capacity, and third one costing. Okay, so these are important in case of work centers. So work center may be a machine or a group of machines or a person also, we can tell. So it's a man-made work centers, or it's a machine-made work centers, whatever it may be. So next one, fourth one, is routing. So routing is a collection of work centers in a production line. So that is what I'm saying. Routing is nothing but a sequence of operations performed at work centers. So it also specifies machine time, labor time, etc. for executing a particular operation or particular sequence of operations. Okay, it is also used for scheduling of operations. Okay, scheduling of operations and used in standard cost calculation of a product. Okay, that is what I'm. It is very important. Routing is mainly used for scheduling of operations and used in standard cost calculation of the product. And finally, the product versions. So the product version is a combination of bill of material called BOM, and in short BOM, and routing data for the product, for the production. So it is a linkage between the bill of material and routing, and determines the manufacturing process. Okay, so therefore there can be a multiple production versions as per the different manufacturing process to produce the product. So normally, what is a production planning cycle? So the production planning cycle and control consists of two obvious processes. One is a planning and next one is an execution. So what is a production planning? So the production planning is generally done from the budgeted sales plan, and planning is based on the sales plan to meet the sales requirement as per the production cycle times. Okay, and demand for the product is entered through the demand management in the form of the planned independent requirements. Okay, planned independent, those are independent, we cannot estimate that. So those are called planned independent requirement, PIR. We can say it is a PIR. So this data from the demand management becomes the input to the material requirements planning, and the material requirement planning, in short we can say MRP, checks for the availability of various raw materials used for the production of different stages. Stages using the such as the master data, such as bill of material and available current plant stocks. Okay, so this is called a planning. And in case of material shortage, the purchase requisition are created for a materials which are externally procured. Okay, it will go for external procurement, outsourcing, if material shortage is available, material shortage observed in the plant level. At a plant level, normally the material search or material valuation, everything can be taken place at a plant level. So so the purchase requisition is generated. Okay, and so the particular materials are externally procured, and then the plant orders are created for an invoice if the material is available in the plant. So raw material is available, or component is available for manufacture to convert it as a finished good. In that case, the system will go for in-house production, planned order for in-house production. So these purchase requisitions and planned orders initiate the procurement cycle and the execution cycle of the production respectively. So now I hope everybody can understood why, in which situation the production order is created, in which situation the purchase order is created. So planned order and purchase requisition, so which is created. So now everybody knows, shortage means it will go for purchase requisition creation, and if material is available, then it will go for planned order creation. So that is the difference. So the MRP works with the infinite capacities. Okay, and capacity leveling must be done in order to avoid any capacity bottlenecks in the sense shortage. Okay, so that is important. That's what MRP works with, the infinite capacity, and capacity leveling must be done in order to avoid any capacity bottleneck. So this is very important. Normally, actually I have faced questions why we need capacity leveling in case of SAP. So it is used to avoid any capacity bottlenecks in a plant. So we are using capacity leveling. It's nothing but a checking. And finally, we have production execution. So these planned orders are converted to production orders and are scheduled as per the production timings. Using the master data such as routings, etc. So production orders are released by the production supervisors or managers on the shop floor. Okay, and the material availability checks are also carried out to carried out to check if there is any missing component present. Okay, and production is carried out based on the activities maintained in the routing. Okay, routing, we are defining the sequence of activities. So the production is carried out based on the activities maintained in the routing, whether where the master data like a work center is maintained against each operation in the routing. So these are to be verified. So once a production order is completed, the confirmation will come place, will come into existence. So confirmation of orders are executed, and goods movement for the material consumption and goods receipt for the materials are posted against the order. Hence, the order gets the delivery status. The production order will get the status GLDLB, that is the delivered status, and our material is received into the desired storage location. Usually at the month end, before doing order settlement, production order needs to be set technically complete. So we can say TECO, right? TECO, technical complete means TECO. So technical complete, the status in order, status in order to calculate the production variances by the controlling personnel. Okay, so this is done at the month end before doing order settlement. So we are doing technically completions. We are moving the order status to technical completion in order to calculate the production variances by the controlling person. So if anyone is asking what are all the stages of production planning process, is nothing but we can tell actually first stage is planned independent requirement, and then actually we have the MPS or MRP running, and from there actually we are, if the stock is available, it will go for planned order creation, and then planned order to production order creation, and if the stock is received at the shop floor from the warehouse, so we are releasing the production order and material is issued to the shop floor, and then actually once the finished goods is manufactured, so production confirmation will take place. Either auto goods issue or auto goods receipt is taken place, depends on the business process. So finally, at the month end closure, so we are doing a production order closure and a settlement. So technically we are completing all these orders. And next comes, we need to talk about demand management. So the function of demand management is to estimate the requirement quantities and delivery dates for the finished products and important assemblies. Okay, if anyone is asking what is the function of demand management means, the function of demand management is to estimate the requirement and the quantity and delivery dates for the finished products and important assemblies. Okay, so that actually we need to consider in our mind. And demand management uses planned independent requirements and customer requirements as an input. So the customer requirements and customer orders. So and the planned independent requirements PIR will be cancelled, and net result will be converted to will be given input to the MRP. So planning strategies must be defined for a product in a material master. So it represents a method of production for planning and manufacturing. So there are two methods by which we can do this. That is, one is make to stock, and the next one is make to order. So what is make to stock? Okay, and what is make to stock means? Make to stock is nothing but production of goods without having sales order. So in the process, therefore, stock is produced independently of the orders without considering the customer orders. Throughout the year, normally actually the make to stock policy is followed in cement plants or chemical plants. They are not considering about the orders, customer orders. Throughout the year they will do, and whenever the customer orders come in or customer ask for the stock, actually they will issue from the existing stored stock. That is called a make to stock. And a make to order is particularly, this strategy is applies to the production of material for a specific or individual sales order or a line item. So this is the make to order is created only based on the customer order and depends on the is a purely or solely depend on the make to order order. So if order is having say for example 20 lines, 20 quantities in a line item, so 20 quantities are manufactured. So we are not going to store by producing excess quantity. Rather than that, actually we are based on the incoming customer orders, we are doing manufacturing. So that is a make to order. That is a major difference. And next comes after coming to the demand management. Now we now talk about material requirement planning. So MRP determines any shortages and creates a appropriate procurement elements. It does net requirement calculation and generate planned orders for an in-house produced material and purchase requisition for the raw material. So already I discussed, if shortage, then purchase requisition, going for outsourcing the going for outsource procurement, and then bring back the stock to the warehouse, issuing the to shop floor, and again converting to planned order, production order, and then running that, releasing the production order, and then converting to the finished goods and releasing the placing that or auto confirmation and placing the stock as a finished goods. So this thing, so the otherwise actually if the stock is available, directly go for planned order, then convert to production, same production process. So this is the main difference. The MRP does lead time scheduling and calculate the production dates in the planned order. Okay, what does MRP will do? MRP will do lead time scheduling and calculate the production dates in the planned orders. And it explores the bill of material and generates the procurement proposals at each BOM level. So it is like an onion peel. So while in cookery, actually they are peeling all the levels of onion, and you can see in the deep most or core, actually we can see the small part of the onion. So like that, actually the system will peel all these things, outer layers, and determine the most required material or a raw material or a component necessary for the building a semi finish. It will determine from semi finish, it will determine what are all the semi finish required for completing converting as a finished good. So it is not, that is called actually it is issuing a procurement proposal at each BOM level, that is semi finish level, when searching the at semi finish level the BOM generates a proposal if shortage, and if it is semi going for semi finish, then it will if any shortage generate a proposal, if going for raw material further at level 0, so if any shortage, then it will go for procurement proposal. Like that, it will for each level it will give one procurement proposal. So after we have one planning method called master production scheduling, MPS. So in that, actually the capital budget purchase, for example, in case of already explained in my earlier videos, see for example in case of power plant or cement plant, the biggest costliest capital assets will be procured through a plan, through a MPS, and whereas MRP we can plan for the very cheap material, cheaper materials, whereas MPS is for costliest material. So in a power plant, we can say the boilers are the costliest, or asset materials, or turbine as asset material. So those are planned through a MPS. That is a different MRP. We can even bolts and net, very low cost materials can be planned through MRP, from higher to lower MRP is used. And next we need to talk about capacity planning and leveling. Sorry, capacity planning and leveling. So the capacity planning, I can say it is used to analyze the capacity overloads. Okay, it is what are all the overloads in a particular capacity at work center, and say if any bottlenecks is there or not, and shifts the orders to avoid any capacity bottlenecks. Okay, I think actually people can get all this requirement what I am saying. The capacity planning is used to analyze the capacity overloads at a particular work center and shift the orders to avoid any capacity bottlenecks. You are getting right. Actually, say for example, particular lathe workstation, right? Lathe is considered as a workstation. So it is having overload. So what system will do? It will shift that the rest of the work to be the next thing, and so thereby avoid the capacity bottlenecks. Bottlenecks means actually bottleneck means it is a overload or problem in managing the workload. So say for example in some particular demand, say for example discrete manufacturing industry, only this will happen. Say particular workstation will get more number of pieces to work other than the next work center will wait for the predecessor work center completion. So for example lathe work center is there, it is having, we need to shape that particular discrete product. So next comes, we need to fine tune that and shape we need to give to shaper. So shaper is waiting for this lathe machine to complete all the products. So there is a delay time or waiting time for the shaper, the next work center, for the predecessor, that is lathe center, to complete all these jobs finish. So there is this will be a bottleneck in production lines. So this is to be avoided and properly planned, and capacity is properly utilized, resources are properly utilized. So I think actually I already told, actually Gold Rat actually wrote actually the book called Goal, which explains the capacity bottlenecks, and he explained how, what is the inventory optimization, how it is to be handled. So everything in a particular plant or in any industry, so it is well explained. So please go through the book The Goal, written by Elias with Goldratt, I think. So that is a very beautiful, very very beautiful book written by Goldratt, I think. So that actually every production planning or an ERP or SCM person should undergo that book, so they can understand how to handle the inventory optimize and how to avoid the bottlenecks in particular manufacturing or any industry. So that is really super book. It's a Bible for the supply chain management and manufacturing process. Okay. So next is, okay, we can go to our topic. Okay, it is deviating totally. So capacity requirements. Okay. So capacity requirements are generated via MRP on your work center. And since MRP works with the infinite capacity and plans everything plans everything on your work center without considering any capacity constraints. So there is no gap constraints. So it is required to level the capacity at the work center. So again, I'm telling, capacity requirements are generally or I can say generated via MRP on your work center. And since MRP works with a finite capacity and plans everything on a work center without considering any capacity constraints. Okay, it is required to level the capacity in the work center, and capacity can be leveled at each work center through a planning table. So we have the planning table entries maintained in the planning table. So in order to create a constrained production plan. Okay, capacity can be leveled at each work center through a planning table in order to create a constrained production plan. Okay, that is we need to consider very important. Production planning files are very important. And next comes our production order. Before that, we have the planned order is there. It is just a request for a production department to create a production order to manufacture a particular material. So planned order is a preliminary, like PR to PO conversion, right? Like that, actually in PP we are doing planned order to production order conversion. So it is a request document. But production order is a very important thing because it involves lot of costing and profitability analysis, integration with the FI and everything is required. So CO part is very important in case of production, production orders. So I like to talk about production orders. So when we find time for the next coming videos, we can talk about planned orders. Okay. And now I'm like to discuss about production orders. So what are production orders? Okay, so the output of MRP will be a planned order. I mean, in case actually the output, normally it is an output of an MRP is a planned order, and in case due to the business requirement, we can directly go for production order without going for planned order. Okay, which needs to be converted to the production orders for converting the production order. And in sometimes depends on the business requirement, the output of MRP I already told the planned orders, okay, which needs to be converted to a production order for further execution of the process. The production order is formed sorry for the disturbance. So the production order is formed is a formed receipt element which is not affected by the MRP run, okay, and like the planned orders. Okay, so the production order is a document which specifies that material needs to be produced and in what quantity, what is the quantity and how the material to be produced. So it also contains the bill of material components and routing operation data to be performed at the work center. And secondly, the production order is released for the execution, and the material availability checks can be carried out with the which determines if there is any missing components or not. So again, I'm telling, the production order is a document which specifies what material need to be produced at what quantity. Okay, it also contains the bill of material components and routing operation data to be performed in the work center. The production order is normally released for the execution, and material availability checks can be carried out which determines if there is any missing component in the stock or not. So finally, we have the production order confirmation. Okay, so when goods are produced physically at the shop floor, then the production order must be confirmed. Okay, and finished goods are available, and the goods are available at the shop floor, then the production order must be confirmed. During the confirmation, the component materials can be consumed automatically via a backflush mechanism, and goods receipt of material can be performed automatically via the operation control key maintained at the routing. Okay, we can do automatic backflushing, or we can do manual backflushing also allowed in the PP. However, instead of automatic goods movement, manual goods issue and receipt can be performed separately from the confirmation. Okay, issue from the production department and goods receipt at the warehouse department. That is possible. Any failed goods movement due to the deficit of components, shortage of component stock, can be reprocessed manually. Okay, any deficit means we need to reprocess it manually. So actually, cost of such as machine cost, labor cost, etc., will also be updated in the production order during the confirmation on an actual basis. Okay, the order gets CNF, that is confirmed, and DLV means delivered status after final confirmation and final goods receipt. Okay, that's what, when the order gets CNF, that is confirmed status, and when the order gets delivered status, so everything is very important. So those status will be updated to the order based on the final confirmation and the final goods receipt. That is the answer. So if the confirmation is posted wrongly, then we can cancel the confirmation and post it again with the correct data. Okay, and the production order close. Okay, final step is a production order close. After the production order is delivered completely, or we don't want to execute the order further, then order should be technically completed. That is, technically complete means actually closing means it is a forced closing of a production order. Okay, and after the orders are gets technically, that is TECO status, technically closed, it gets deleted from the stock bar requirement list. That is, you can see that in MD04 list, and it is no longer considered in the material requirement planning run. Okay, so those material will not be considered. If it is deco, mainly it is not considering in the planning run, MRP planning run, and also it is removed from the stock bar requirement list. So all dependent reservations are also get deleted from the system. So if anybody are asking in interview, or if anybody is asking, what is the purpose of TECO status in production order, means the particular material which is available, which is included in the production order, which is having the status TECO, then actually those material, those are not available in the stock bar requirement list in MD04. We can check it. And second thing, it is not considered for the material requirement planning run. And thirdly, all the dependent requirements also get deleted from the system. Okay, so I think actually the details have given in the production planning run process is very useful to everybody. So in my next video, I like to give in detail on the each and every important components like bill of material, routing, and production order, planned order, and confirmation, and then say for example production order close. Each steps I would like to explain MRP, MPS, and everything that is demand management. Everything I will discuss in detail. I think the video actually I have presented is very useful to each and everyone. Thanks for listening my production planning video. This is Shivakumar signing off.